Hello. In this tutorial, we're going to briefly go through the advantages of having an alpha channel, that's a transparency channel, on your VJing clips. Basically, I've got here this cassette clip from my VJ pack cassette, which is available on Gumroad, which includes an alpha channel, as you can see here on the preview monitor. And then I've got exactly the same clip on here without the alpha channel. To make this more obvious, I'm going to trigger a background clip on layer one. And as expected, while we've got the clip with no alpha, we can't see anything. So I'm going to trigger the one with alpha. And again, as expected, we get to see the background and we see the clip over it exactly defined as intended. All the elements of the clip are clearly visible. Now, you could say that you could achieve a very similar effect by applying an auto mask effect on the clip with no alpha, which we're going to do now. So I've got auto mask here, which is disabled. I'm just going to enable it. And we see a similar effect, but we'll be comparing side by side in a second. If you look closely, we've got a loss of definition. The way AutoMask works is it uses the tonality of the clip to decide which bits are see-through and which bits are not. Especially when you've got grayscale ranges in your clip, you lose a lot of detail on it, which is not what the intention is originally. That's the clip with no alpha with the AutoMask enabled. I'm now going to trigger the clip with alpha. And as you can see, the definition of the clip is greatly enhanced and it appears exactly as intended. Black elements appear solid, so you can't see through them, which is not what happens on the clip with no alpha. If you look down at this bottom part of the clip, there's got those little circular holes of the cassette. They are see-through on the clip with AutoMask. What this means is that although AutoMask can be a very versatile and effective tool to use when you've been handed over clips with no transparency on them, if you're creating your own material or you're buying a VJ pack, it's a really good idea, especially with certain types of clips that you probably be using on your top layers, to have them with the alpha channel so that they appear exactly as they are meant to be and you don't lose any definition, any detail, or anything else. We're going to go into a few more comparisons of how you can use clips with alpha channels to their best. I'm going to now turn off the background layer. I'm going to go to the clip with no alpha and switch off the auto mask. And I'm going to trigger the clip with alpha. So now on this layer three, I've got here a video router with an effect stack, which has been taken from my text effects pack, also available on Gumroad. There's another tutorial on how to reuse effect stacks, like in this case. So you can go to the link and have a look at that if you're interested in learning how to reuse effect stacks. But I'm going to just trigger the volcano effect, which is like a flame fire kind of effect. And I'm going to tweak it a slight bit using my dashboard controls. All this you can find on the tutorial on how to use effect stacks. Let's turn down the flames a bit, maybe turn up the heat. So basically what we've got here is this kind of slightly growing sparkly effect on the cassette. And we're going to compare it to what that looks like if we just use the clip with no alpha and no auto mask on it. As you can see, the effect is limited to just the bright areas and we don't get any of the halo that we get on the clip with alpha on it. See, we've got all the glowing edges, the slight flames. If I turn up the flames on the volcano effect, you'll see more of that. Going back to the clip with no alpha, still gives us an interesting effect, but not quite what the intention is. So as you can see, it's a lot more intense and makes much more of a difference to the overall impact of the effect on the clip when you've got the alpha channel in it. Let's now compare how the effect clip behaves when we use it on the clip with no alpha with auto mask enabled. So now we're looking at the clip with alpha. So if I trigger the one with no alpha and enable the auto mask on it, that allows us to see more of the halo. And again, it's an interesting effect. It might be what you're after, but we've lost a lot of definition on the clip. So let's compare side by side. So this is the clip with no alpha and auto mask. We see a trace of the contours of the cassette, but we've lost all the definition of all the elements of it. If we go back to the clip with alpha, we can see that we've got that element that is moving from left, clearly visible. The reels of the cassette are clearly visible. The screws, the holes, all the details clearly visible. If we go to the clip with no alpha and auto mask on it, it's all a bit washed out. We've lost a lot of the detail of the original clip. Let's look a bit more how having an alpha channel affects what we're doing. Right now, I've added a solid color as the background layer so that we can see exactly what is happening. It's just mid-gray so that we can see the darker elements that we're going to add onto it. So this is our clip with alpha playing on it at the moment. And I've got here a drop shadow, which is disabled, and I'm just going to enable now. And as you can see, all the different elements of the clip are casting a shadow. To contrast this with the clip with no alpha, I'm going to click on it, and it's got no auto mask on it. So as expected, we don't see the background at all. Let's first enable our auto mask on it. And as you see, the definition is completely gone. The contrast is non-existent, and we just see a faint trace of what the clip should be. The colors of the clip haven't actually changed. What's changed is the opacity of the elements. So things that should be completely solid are now different levels of transparency based on their brightness. If we add the drop shadow, you see how that is affected by the fact that the elements are not completely solid. So the cast shadow is not quite there. And we actually see through some of the elements that should be solid. Simple as the drop shadow effect is, I find it to be extremely useful and very versatile to do compositing and achieve all kinds of effects from very simple VJ clips. So being able to use drop shadow in the best possible manner opens up the doors to manipulating your clips into loads of possibilities. This 3D effect is an example of what you can achieve with clever use of drop shadows, but there's a whole other tutorial explaining how to do this, so you can check that out if you're interested. So to finish off, here's another example of how effect stacks work really nicely when your clips have got that alpha channel already in it. But that will be it for this tutorial. Like always, please like and subscribe if you want to stay tuned for more Resolume tutorials. Thanks for watching.